Premier, thanks for joining us.
Very good to be with you.
Victorians are facing a long and a tough road out of these lockdowns. Why is the Victorian government effectively pursuing a strategy that is close to eradication when other states, like New South Wales, are getting by simply by suppressing the virus?
Well, given the amount of community transmission, the amount of mystery cases that we have now and we've seen in Victoria, we need to get these numbers down to very low levels so that we can be confident that when we open up in a safe and steady way, we can stay open. It's really difficult to make comparisons with other states because in many respects, the circumstances we face, the challenge that we face is very, very different.
Premier, you've set these very high thresholds to move through these stages. For instance, there needs to be a statewide average of fewer than five cases over a 14-day period before retail reopens to some extent, before people other than singles can visit other people's homes. Are you worried this is too strict? Because the Prime Minister today made the point that under the current arrangements, Sydney too would also be under curfew.
Well, I don't think it would be because Sydney's not had the amount of community transmission that we've had. So I don't think that's a particularly valid comparison and not a particularly worthwhile one. We're not in New South Wales. We've got a set of unique circumstances that apply to Victoria and a roadmap to safely and steadily ease out of these current rules, these current restrictions, to find a COVID normal, to open up and to stay open. The key point here is that in the last month, we've gone from 725 cases about a month ago, 41 cases today. So we are seeing very significant reductions in the number of people who've got this virus, the chains of transmission, mystery cases. The strategy's working, but if you open up too much too early, you don't stay open for long, Michael, and that's not what we want.
Have you modelled how many businesses in Victoria will now go under as a result of these extended restrictions?
Well, there's no question that there's significant pain and there's a real challenge there, we know that. We'll have more to say about business support. This is about saving lives and it's also about saving livelihoods, because the point here, Michael, is the notion of spending the rest of this year and pretty much all of 2021 bouncing in and out of lockdowns every 4 weeks or so. There can be no economic recovery until we deal with the health issue. So you've got to do this in a sequential and logical way, and that's exactly the plan that we've outlined.
I get the health imperative, but there's surely going to be pain here. I'll ask that question again. Have you modelled how many businesses will go under as a result of this plan?
There's a whole lot of modelling. In terms of trying to be definitive about those sorts of questions, that's very, very challenging. Of course, we have to meet all the targets that we have laid out. We need to have more to say, and we will soon, about the business support that we will offer to business. And I just want to be really clear, we will spend these next few days, this next week or so, consulting in a very detailed way with different sectors to craft a package of support that, in their judgment, meets their needs. It's not about simply imposing that, it's about listening and trying to craft a package that will be of the greatest impact. So until you settle some of those matters, it's very difficult to answer the question you've asked.
Premier, there's concern that Victoria's contact tracing system, which clearly wasn't fit for purpose at the start of the second wave, is still not up to scratch, is it?
Well, there's certainly a lot of commentary being run, but as the person who's here on the ground with a very detailed understanding of the amount of work that a team of 2,600 committed people are doing, let me say that we are getting to almost 100% of every positive case within 24 hours. There'll always be a handful of people who are not home, can't be found where they perhaps would be thought to be. We're getting to literally 100% of all close contacts within 48 hours. They are national benchmarks. We haven't made our own rule book here. We are absolutely delivering against the nationally agreed thresholds. We report those in a proper way, an open and transparent way. We're always looking for improvement though.
There's concern by some epidemiologists today that you're not being as transparent as you should be in releasing the full modelling underpinning your roadmap. Should you do that to inspire more confidence amongst Victorians?
Always happy to release as much information as we can. We are reporting across the board in many different ways to give people that real-time insight into what's going on. Again, what I know, with the greatest of respect to all the people that you've just quoted and potentially many more, there are many different opinions in the medical community and the research community. That's a healthy thing. That's why our scientific and medical community in Victoria is so highly regarded across the world. But ultimately, you have to settle these things. You have to make a decision and then you have to get on and get the job done. We can't have an endless debate amongst eminent, very highly qualified people. I'm not having any, there's no criticism there, But ultimately, this is not an academic exercise. It's about getting to the other side of this, opening up safe, steady and staying open.
Premier, there's a lot riding on this for you politically. While you're fighting the virus, this inquiry into the hotel quarantine bungle is continuing. The inquiry has heard that 99% of cases in the second wave were from return travellers. Now, you have been refreshingly upfront about the buck stopping with you, about being accountable, and you've also said that you intend leading the government to the next election. But if this inquiry comes back and lays the blame squarely at your feet, will you consider your position?
Well, my position, Michael, and the responsibility that I have is to see our state through this, and that's exactly what I'm focused on. Let me be, as you said in your question and your acknowledgement, let me be as frank as I can be. Politics has never mattered less to me. Leadership is not about doing what's popular, it's about doing what's right. And that's exactly the decisions I made yesterday, and I will continue to lead in that fashion. This is about a fight with only one thing, and that's this wildly infectious virus. The politics of this, that is of no value. The only thing that matters is we all stay the course, we all keep following the data, the science and the doctors, and get this done. Then move to the biggest economic repair job that our state has ever seen.
Premier, thanks for your time.
Thanks very much for having us on.
Hi, I'm Lee Sales. Thanks for watching this story. If you'd like to watch more of 7:30's stories, they are on the left of your screen. And tap on the button below to subscribe and get the latest from ABC News.